Hey guys, welcome to Surfin' Show. I'm Noel Salas, and today's surfboard review is on the Swordfish by Lost Surfboards. Now I have two stock PU poly boards. I have a 5.5 coming in at 26 liters, and I have a 5.4 coming in at 25 liters. Stoked to say, special guest Nate Yeomans will be joining us for this review. And if you like the show and you haven't subscribed by now, do so and give us a thumbs up if you like the content. This is going to be a great review, so get your favorite drink, sit back, enjoy the show. Now, as we dive into the Swordfish, I want to first talk about where it came from. This is a Kolohe Andino model inspired from the RNF Retro. RNF stands for Round Nose Fish. Now, I reviewed that board in the past. Stock dimensions, 5'2", roughly 27 and some change liters. And the reason I talk about its length is because this is a Swordfish at 5'5". So 3 inches longer on the Swordfish, and it's got a pointed nose instead of the round nose. That extra 3 inches in length gives me a longer rail line to drive off my bottom turns, and it's starting to feel and look more like a high performance shortboard, because as you see, the outline is a lot narrower in the nose compared to the RNF, but maybe still a bit wider than the Driver 2.0. Now, some of the things that I want to talk about in the changes is not just the performance outline, but the RNF had great glide, incredible speed, and with the double side cut tail, offered excellent traction. Now, did those changes translate well to the Swordfish? Absolutely. This board's really fast, it's got get up and go speed, and it's super loose with the traction I'm looking for because it doesn't have a lot of tail rocker. Now the other thing I want to mention is that they increased a little bit of nose rocker on the Swordfish compared to the RNF. Now on the bottom contours, from what I understand, it's the same. It's a light single into a spiral V out the tail. And with it being 5.5 in the stock dimensions compared to the 5.2 RNF that I had, the whole thing's going to be a little bit narrower, right? It's going to be a little bit sleeker. What we're looking for, and I believe this is what Kolohe was after, is giving us that fishy speed and vibe by adding a performance feature that the RNF couldn't offer with the design being so round up in the nose. We're going to look at some waves together. We're going to compare the Swordfish and RNF Retro on similar turns on a few waves, so you can see what I'm talking about. So here's the Swordfish, nice top turn. What I really want you guys to see is how I'm surfing the Swordfish with a lot more performance. I have more rail line to push off of compared to the RNF here. Still doing good turns, but all my turns are shorter and quicker on the RNF because I have less rail line to work with. Nice top turn, nice little wrap right there. Swordfish looking good compared to the RNF. Nice top turn, watch it bog or catch right here. And that tends to happen with a smaller fish type board with a big round nose. See the Swordfish top to bottom? Got a good performance look and feel to it, as opposed to the RNF. Leaning back a bit, coming off the bottom, still doing good turns. Watch it catch. And that's the difference between the RNF and the Swordfish. Now I want to talk about which one of the two stock boards I like best. Now I got great waves on both. And the way we edited the footage, you won't be able to tell the difference, but I'm choosing the 5.5. And what I liked about the 5.5 is it had more flow, more speed, more glide. They both paddled well, but that one extra inch in rail line really made the difference on giving me more performance through my turns. Now the 5.4, there's a lot of footage that didn't make it in the review because at times I was bogging on this board, and I'll tell you why. It wasn't so much the leaders at 25. I just felt like the sweet spot was smaller. So much so that when my feet were off just a little bit, mostly my front foot, it was catching and bogging and making it hard for me to get a series of turns that were good enough from my perspective. Now, when I ordered both these boards, they didn't have the Mason Ho Exactadims coming in at 5.6 at 26 liters, which I think would even suit me better. Now, if you run into these options, like I am, and you're not sure which way to go, that's why I bring this up. Take the longer one and utilize the rail and the design. The board's loose, quick, and responsive, and you'll love it. Now I want to talk about the fins I chose. And I found the Swordfish to be very versatile as I chose multiple fin setups. I went twin fin, thruster, quad, and twin plus trailer, and I liked the thruster the best. And not just any thruster set, I really felt like it shined bright with a pivot set. Now, I chose the Peregrine Size Large by Naked Viking because I wanted the quickness and agility in the pocket, especially when I'm on a board that doesn't have a ton of rocker. So this felt the best right here. Now, I did run Jordy's, which is a lot more rake, and I felt like it had more drive, but because it doesn't have a lot of rocker, at times I felt like it would catch across here, just kind of bog a little bit. So then I put in the Twin Plus trailer, and I chose another pivot set. This is the AMT, and I'm a huge fan of these and these types of board. We've got incredible speed, and I want that pivot, so I've got this little trailer fin to help me have that traction. And this setup and this setup right here were my favorite. Now, I didn't stop there. I also ran a quad set. This is John Pizell's with, this is a medium with his medium quad rears. And this felt good too. It was fast, faster than the thruster. It was projecting well down the line, but it still kind of wasn't pivoting as good as I'd like. So that's why I chose the thruster. Now, the last thing I'll say is I ran the Elmer Keel twin set in here, and it was a little bit too loose for waves that were head high and over. But I feel like if I put it in maybe some chest high and below waves, it'd even go good as a twin fin. So let's look at some waves together. Nice little right here. The first turn kind of dictates everything. Going to the bottom, getting right into the top, but watch the board, the flow. Rail to rail turns. No hesitation between turn. That felt great. Look at, does the board have a gas pedal? Absolutely. Back to the open face, so down the line's quick. Wave kind of goes flat. Watch the board take off again with very little effort. On this left, getting my footing together, gets me behind, but watch the board. Quick to pick up that speed and project, get me back to the open face. Here's a slower left. I really like this rail turn right here, able to extend both legs through that turn. And then this last right, off the bottom, nice top turn. You see me on this cutback, I get stuck on my heels, but I put it right on rail to finish decent. Always stoked to have Nate Yeomans on the show. Check it out.
What's up, everyone? Nate Yeomans here at Mi Casa, practicing social distancing. I want to thank Serpent Show for having me be involved, and I had a lot of fun riding this board. We're even breaking down Lost new model, the Swordfish. One of my favorite for 2020 as far as what they've released. It's Colonia Dino's model, and it's based off one of my favorites for small waves, was the Roundnose Fish Retro. Quite a bit of similarities. It was inspired from Kolohe riding the Roundnose Fish. This is the LipTech version. We're going to be going over two different techs, and then this is the PU. But yeah, so Kolohe got the Roundnose Fish Retro and sounded like he really liked it, but wanted to push the envelope a little bit more in the high performance realm. So he met with Matt, they stretched out the rail line, gave it a bit more nose and rocker up and through the nose, and just narrowed it a little bit. And that added rail line gives the board just a bit more hold. And I think they did a great job. Super driving, and overall, I think the number one characteristic that would describe this board is just fast. I was blown away at how much speed this board has just from the get-go. I think at times, to be ultra critical, it's actually too fast for certain waves. I had at lowers when I was filming with Noel, there was a couple clips where you actually, the board carries so much speed, you kind of get outside of the pocket, but I'm totally fine. If that's the downside of the board, then that's a good board to me, because at the end of the day, I'd get out of the water and I'd have a smile on my face, because it just going fast is that much fun. And this board does that quite well. It's really unique too, because it doesn't ride like any other board in the Lost range that I've ridden. It's a five, this PU is a 5.8. 19.5, 2.4, 29.5 liters. And to me, I just really like aesthetically the outline. It just looks like a fun board to ride. Wider point, push forward a little bit. Carries foam out to the rail, so it paddles really well. But for a 5.8, it has hold and it has a lot of drive. And you can really push your turns. And as I said, at times it went out of the pocket because it, I think just with the speed it carries, but then it delivers really big turns and down the line carries that speed. So when the section does present itself, you can really lay into it. I really liked it at the beach breaks. I took this board to Hawaii and surfed it in like 4 foot Hawaiian surf, 3-4 foot. And for a 5.8, you didn't have to baby your surfing at all, which is really cool. So to me, it's like a short board, but it's squashed down, so you get the cool benefits of having the board fit in waves where a shortboard might be a struggle. And then I was really blown away. I was able to ride the LibTech version. And first of all, these boards are, it's epoxy. This one's Kaloi's Exactadem, so it's 5.9, an inch longer, 19 and a quarter, it's a little narrower, 2.38, a tad thinner, and 29 liters. But the durability and the strength these things have is second to none. And in past, I felt in softer waves, these boards were a little stiff, and I liked them in punchier surf, but I know they've changed up the flex pattern in the board and how they're doing the construction, and it just seemed a lot livelier. And I've ridden this board probably 6 times, and it literally doesn't have a pressure ding in it. So as far as durability, A+ performance, they've come a long way, and I was super stoked. Overall, it's been, these boards have been some of my favorite boards to ride over the last 4 or 5 months. All right, quarantine's getting to me. So I'm joining the fad. I wrote a song today about a little board I like to ride called the Swordfish. It's an original. Hello, surfing show fans. Aaron and Noel, thanks for having me on the show. Today we're gonna get creative, and I think you all know I'm at home. There's a virus that's a booming, and I pray God protects us all. Now let's talk about a surfboard. The Swordfish, it's one of my top 5. Well, she's a little beauty. Man, she goes fast. Faster than a bat out of hell. Oh, that's pretty fast. And I like to go a-riding down the trestle's wall. And I hope you enjoy this review. Surfing show's the best of. Yeehaw!
Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed today's review on the Swordfish. I'm calling it a daily driver. I like it best in 2 to 6 foot surf, and I highly recommend it for intermediate all the way to pro level surfers. Nate, thanks for joining us on the show, and I agree with you. I've not surfed anything like the Swordfish in the Lost lineup. Special shout out thanks to Matt Biolas for sending these boards down for review. If you like the show, subscribe. You can also find us at surfandshow.com. Until next time, we'll see you in the water. Bye-bye.